Well, thank you guys for joining us, and sorry for the technical delays. We did change some stuff around. Like I said, I downloaded Windows 10, so it kind of messed a few of the settings up. But now we were up and running and good to go. If everybody can hear us well, we have been working really hard this week, getting a lot of new features in. We've got a ton of new features to show everybody, and done a lot of pretty cool stuff, a lot faster than we actually thought we would. So everything's been going, ahead of schedule. We can kind of run through and show everybody all the things that we've done. I don't know, what would you say would be the thing of most importance?
I'm actually having difficulty remembering what we did this week. So I guess the thing we were doing today was the cavern raider, if you
Oh,
want to do
yeah.
that.
We did get the Cavern Raider up and running. It runs pretty well. You just have to kind of click Find Nearby Cabins. It will give you a list, or caverns, and it'll give you a list of all the caverns near you and kind of place them in order of distance. And then if you want to add one, you just go to Add, and it will automatically populate with all of the troops you have in that city. And then if you want to, you can then go into count, and you can change the count. So let's say I want five to go out, then it will automatically split the troops you have in your city by five. So then you can have five outgoing raids with the troops that it shows in the box, instead of if you go to two, it will only split your troops at home by half. So basically, you can go all the way up to as many command slots as you have, and it will split them all the way down. So that way you get even numbers of all your at-home troops, and then you can manually change them as well. So if you don't want to send that many, you can change them around some and make them whatever you want. But this kind of helps split up your raid. So if you're shooting through cities pretty quickly, it lets you set them up fast. And then it's got all the different options down here. You can see the amount of troops in your city. You can choose what time you want to send all of them at. So you can do until the cavern closes, or you can do them once. You can set the departure time, and also you can set the interval. So if you want to, have all of your raids split by 1 minute apart, so it gives time for things to process and for troops to rebuild, you could set them to, go out at 1 minute apart, and then if you click raid, it will automatically set them all up and give you some pending raids that go out at the different times. So as you can see, they're 1 minute apart. So that all works pretty as well as the idle units. You can go into idle units, and it will show you all of the units you have idle. This one is not counting the pending troops, which I think is right because they're still in the city. And then next to it, you can see the icons of what troops you have in that city, how many you've got that are just sitting around idle, all the different troop city names, and then a go-to button. And then you can sort your troops by the different types and the different continents. So that should help people, and you can even use it for senators, so it should help people in game to find where those senators are hanging around that shouldn't be in there. Let's see, we did put it in the market.
Yeah, we put in the marketplace.
So if you put it, go into trades, you can put orders up on the market, and they can you can trade by land or sea, and you can just put up any amount. And it will kind of go in there, and then you can see other people's trades as well. You can actually go into an all cities view, so you can see every trade your empire has, as well as just the trades in this empire or in this city. And you can go into the marketplace and search it, and you can see, if somebody has an order up, say you want to buy it, you can choose the amount that you want to buy. So let's say I only want to buy 10, and it costs me, 10,000 gold for the 10, and I accept it. And then I should get a purple, because purple is for marketplace transactions. 10,000 wood coming in. Let's say I want to buy the rest of it. And now I have the rest of the marketplace incoming. So markets are working, and working well. They have their own color, so you can tell your market trades apart from the other trades.
We have a question about the rating tool real quick.
Okay.
Does it automatically calculate what you should send out or no? Not
Nope.
yet.
No, it's not
Okay.
going to. If you know, I not only need to set up for you, but tell you how much you should send, then you know, I'm basically playing the game for you. So you guys need to figure out what you should send to your own dun or you know, your own caverns. But if the game just sat there and told you send this many, first of all, you're gonna get mad if you know a certain number of them die because you know the game told you wrong. So you know that's more of a player thing than a game thing. So we're not ever going to really tell you how many troops you should send at any given cavern. You know, that's up to you guys to decide what you want to send to each one. Currently, there are no limits on the market based on rank. We have not, you know, thought about putting those in. We might put them in. If we do put them in, it would probably be
Basically,
for the
we're like
lives.
seeing how it goes, and if people are abusing it or something, that we can see, or if there's a need to introduce it, then we can. But so far, no.
Yeah, we'll see how it goes in the beta, and then too many people are doing crazy trades or something's fishy, then we can certainly put them in.
Yeah, exactly.
Will we allow game calcs? I mean, we'll allow you to do your own calculations, but we're not going to put calculations for the game inside the game because, you know, that kind of makes it a little too easy. If somebody wants to write, you know, some kind of script or something that goes over top, that's fine. But as far as putting it directly into the game, I think it kind of takes away the point of actually playing the game if everything's already
Yeah,
calculated
it
and
kind of
you don't have to
defeats the
think for
purpose.
yourself. Not only that, but you know, it's a up for debate which is the best for any given time. So, you know, our numbers might not be the right ones for what people want to do.
Fact would like to know on the rating tool if you can have a choice to leave a reserve percent at home, so that the raid isn't automatically canceled if not enough are recruited before they come home to go back out.
We could probably add that because it's not a
Yeah,
bad
all right,
idea.
so.
We could have like a percentage down at the bottom or something. You know, maybe just like populate it with 0, 5, 10, 15, or 20, you know. And then we could take that into
Yeah.
account when it you know, does the count and everything like that.
We
So
can
yeah,
do that.
it's a good idea. Actually, a lot of the things that we've put into the game were things that weren't actually in other games. They were just scripts that people wrote, but we decided to put them straight in because people liked them so much. So, you know, to put that in is, you know, to put the other stuff in that's more of a player-based things, and it makes it easy for people to go in and fool around and you know, write their own script to modify this, but at least it's in there for people who want to play the betas. And I'm sure somebody will come up with something better eventually, and that's fine with me as well. So yeah, markets work, and alliance forms work, although I'm not an alliance currently because I did reset my account. Which is another thing we put in, which was you can now reset your account We did put in a safety mechanism, so you do have to request a code that goes to your email address. Once you get the code, then you can copy and paste it into this box, and then you can reset your account. But kind of keeps people from hijacking your account and resetting it without having access to your email. So that does work. It does clean your entire empire out. We did put in lawless
cities.
Abandoned. So we do have abandoned cities. And although the labels are off at the moment. Probably because my internet was jumping when I started the game up. But we do have abandoned cities. Let me see if I can abandon one here for everybody.
Salty has a good question, and possibly catching a bug with keeping a reserve amount home before it happens is, if you keep 5% at home, then how is it going to recognize that it needs to replace dead troops?
Oh, no, the 5% would basically just be in the calculation that I have in the raider that splits your troops for you. So it would just keep the 5% out of the calculation. So it wouldn't actually, retain 5% of your troops anywhere. It would just do it in the raider in the calculation.
Steeltown has a great question. This has been addressed before, but we might as well refresh everybody. People will not keep their rank after resetting, right? They lose all research, everything, right?
They lose everything.
They lose literally everything except their denarii.
Yep, so when you reset everything except your denarii, which isn't game dependent, gets reset, your rank, your purified resources, your research, it's basically like starting brand new on a new account. The number of continents is based on both the amount of people on the continent that opened before it, and a time variable. So if it doesn't reach that number of people or cities on that continent, then after a period of time, it'll open on its own. But if it does reach it, it will open instantly and start dumping new players onto a new continent. So no matter how many people came, it would just keep opening up continents faster and faster and dropping people on new continents. So basically, the back end of the server will open continents based on the need of the amount of people playing. So it kind of runs itself in that regard. So it doesn't matter how many people play, and if we get 50,000 people who jump onto a server at one time, it'll just open up all of the continents at once and drop them all over the place.
Siege partial withdrawal is in, right? Or
siege,
going to be in?
Siege partial withdrawal is in.
Yay!
As well as reinforcement partial withdrawal.
Excellent. Ares would like to know if 22 is going to be the first continent open for Beta 3, and how many people you're going to let settle on 22 before the next continent opens.
22 is going to be the main continent, mostly because it's in the center of the map, so that's why it kind of stays as the main continent. It will, it opens after a period of time. I'm not sure if I want to give out that period of time, because I know people do like to jump continents and wait. So I think it's going to be more of something where people are going to have to figure it out for themselves or guess. But if I told everybody the exact criteria of a new continent opening, then you'd have more and more people sitting around and waiting, which isn't as much fun as having to guess when you log on and what server you'll be in. So as you can see, I'm sieging Ala now. You can open it up and you can do a partial siege. So I can only, say I want to recall 10,000. It will not let me do it if I've got my command slots full. But if I don't have my command slots full, then I can do a partial withdrawal, and it will create like a second attack that returns while the other one keeps going. if my command slots are full, I can do a, you can always do a full and recall everything, and then it won't count against your command slots. So that does work, as well as the reinforcements kind of work the same way. So I guess I can reinforce it real quick and show everybody.
Another real quick question. If you reset, you automatically go to a new 3-point city and that's it. You start all over, right? There's no time between when you can log back in or anything?
No time between when you can log back in. You reset, you get shot back to the home screen, and you log in again like your first time ever playing. The abandoned cities do degrade too. They degrade over time, and when they hit 3 or 7 points, they turn into ruins and can no longer be settled. There is a time limit on, or a wait period on abandoned cities. So depending on the player who abandons rank, depends on whether or not you can actually settle the city.
Settle
yet.
Them straight away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or if you have to wait. So, as you can see, reinforcing, then you get the kind of the same window as sieges. And then you can either withdraw some of them, and some come home, or you can withdraw all of them. So, that is fully functional and working as well. And let's see if I can... I think one of these is mine. You know what, I might just abandon somebody else's city. Just so everybody can see it. Whoever this is, I'm sorry, but I am abandoning your city. And as you can tell, we have not reset things yet, just because I've wanted to work more on the processing load and things like that. So keeping a lot of buildings on the server kind of allows me to do that.
Can reinforcements be timed to arrive as well as raids? No.
Not yet, but they will be probably like by the stream next week, as they will have that in.
Excellent.
Reinforcements getting
so you can time arrival or departure.
I think I've got that in already.
For reinforcements, you don't.
We already have the continent ranking, or rankings by continent, right?
Yep.
What about in the outgoing and incoming? Is that sort by continent in yet?
Not yet, but again, probably by this time next week, I'd say it will be. We kind of started with the big things and are kind of trickling down to the small.
Cool.
Look at that. See?
Oh, there it is. Look at that.
I thought I'd put it in.
Oh.
So yes, we do have a...
And can you do it by departure time as well, or is it only arrival time?
It's only arrival time at the moment. Okay. I haven't put in departure times yet.
Okay, well, we can do that.
And yes, we did do a complete revamp of the rankings. So we put in...
There's the... troop count rankings are in there.
We also put in continents, so you can sort all of the rankings by continent, or you can do all continents. And there's also a search, so if people want to search for somebody, like let's see. So if you start typing, it automatically starts sorted them out. So if you don't know somebody's full name or how it's spelled, you can actually type any part of their name. Like if you just wanted to type ACT, that's an S. Then you get fact, even though you didn't put in the first letter. So the search function works pretty well, and it works for pretty much all of them. We did put in the military tables, where you will see unknowns. It's the same for offense and defense, and all of them have their own continent sorts and searches which work. Same for alliance. It works all the way through temples, I think. So you can, I think temples is the one that I'd want to see the most, is who has the most on each continent. So you can just switch around by continent and see who's got faith on which continent. And then you can also search for players on the continent, or for all continents, and see who has it. So rankings was completely overhauled and works well. We did put in kind of a loading thing, just because now everyone's loading, being loaded on its own and not all at once, which kind of speeds it up at the same time as, allows us to separate things without big loads going back and forth.
Will allowing your name to be seen in the offense and defense rankings be an option?
Yeah, we've been thinking about doing that. Probably something we put in eventually, but not like one of our top priorities.
It would probably be, like mid beta 3 rather than before, because it's kind of further down the list of things to do. But yeah, we will have that in at some point. At the moment, it's set to the default of it shows to people in your alliance, but not to others.
So that was another big thing that we did. And it does not let me abandon somebody else's city, so I did a good job at whatever I did. But I will abandon one of my own. So you can go in here and abandon. It gives you a pop-up. It automatically moves you to another city after you've abandoned it. You do get a pop-up for everybody in the area. The castle one, I need to put the coordinates in. But it will tell you the coordinates, so everybody within a certain range of the abandoned gets a pop-up that says, this city has been abandoned. And then I should have made sure that the labels were loaded before I started the stream.
Are there any set times to taking an abandoned city? Like, it'll deteriorate over time, right?
It deteriorates over time, and there is a set time for things to deteriorate as well. So after a certain point, when it gets to a certain level, it'll turn into ruins, and then you can't settle it. But depending on the player who abandoned its rank, depends how long. Ally, you've got a lower rank, don't you? You can abandon one, and we can show everybody the little red warning that pops up if...
Let's see. I don't know what ones you'll get.
There's a little warning that shows up that says you can't settle something or can settle something, depending on the time that it becomes available. You can abandon during a siege. You can also... As you can see, I got a pop-up that shows me that one of the cities around me has been abandoned. So I can click on it and I can go and I can see that it was an abandoned city. And then you get a little, the city is still being abandoned, and at a random time within a time frame based on her rank when she abandoned it is when it will become available, and then I can settle.
Did you say you can or cannot abandon while being sieged?
You can.
Okay.
You can abandon while being sieged. You can pretty much abandon at any time. Subs do have an abandon limit. based on the person they're subbing's rank. So people who are subs can only bend in, you know, so many a day. And that's also in the options where you can allow people to abandon or not abandon. We do have the substitution system completely in. It does work. You can substitute people and go into their accounts. You can also, you know, ask for subs. I put in kind of like an auto finder thing. So, I can't use it because that's why. So if I don't have a sub, I can start typing a name here for the person I want to sub, and it will start giving me a list of players to select from. So you
Fax has an interesting question. If you abandon during a siege, does the siege take reset or does it just keep going? I think it just keeps going.
It just keeps going. So if somebody abandons right before, you know, your capping siege attack, it will keep going. You'll cap it on the next hit. So it doesn't reset sieges. But this feature here allows people to request subs without having to worry about typos and putting in the wrong names. You can just kind of you know, start typing in letters and it will give you a list of everybody, and then if you want to request it, you just click their name and send the request and they will get a mail. We've also got the limitations in, so the number of people days when you reset your account, your number of days active on this world completely resets too. So it really is just like a brand new account.
Skeletown wants to know, what if you reset before the siege hits?
I guess it would be the same.
It'd be the same. Reset just abandons every city you have and deletes your account.
That was a good question.
It also deletes all the attacks. So let's say you're attacking somebody and you abandon the city you're attacking from or castle. All of those attacks get canceled too.
Excellent.
So we do have the substitution system in, which was another big thing that we had to put in.
Steelmint, what if you abandon a city before a siege hit? Will it still land?
Yes. Depending on your rank. No, it doesn't matter for a castle. Castles don't have any rank limitations or don't take any time to abandon. So if you abandon right before somebody starts a siege, the siege will continue on like normal. It just won't have anybody defending against it.
Except for whatever troops you had left in the city.
Right. I did put in where you can change your flag color.
You won't be able to support an abandoned city or castle, right?
Nope.
Excellent.
Another feature that we need to put in for next week is to mark players or alliances on Worldview.
Yep, we got to. That's one of the things we're going to be doing next. That and adding things to the queue without having the resources.
Oh yeah, queue with counselor.
So we're going to do that as well in the next coming week.
But and the other thing is. Actually, not a feature that many people used, but some people have been asking for it, is request resources in trade. So I guess we can put that in too.
One question about queuing with Counselor. You'll be able to queue ahead of your Basilica level too, right?
Yeah, you'll be able to queue pretty much anything. And then, except for palaces or temples, we will not allow queuing of temples. But you'll be able to queue
anything. A couple of people have been asking, so like what a lot of people would do with military build cities in particular is like, you know, build a load of cottages, cabins, and would then like delete 8 and queue 8 barracks, and like you'll be able to do that where you are able to queue buildings ahead of time even if you don't have a slot.
Yes. Basically, we're going to treat the queue like a suggestion. So you can you can queue as much or anything that you want. It's going to take up one of your build slots. But, you know, if you've got 100 buildings and you want to queue 110 more, you can have those 10 pending sitting there. And then you'll just only have 6 spots. So that's how I'm going to do it, is make it so that you can basically queue whatever you want. And if it doesn't meet the requirements, it won't go through.
Die Faster would like to know if there's a time period before you can reset. Like, say you just started the world, 2 weeks later you want to reset. Is there a limit before you can reset?
Yeah, I'm probably going to put in some kind of limit. You know, probably be like 2 days or something like that before you can reset. So it'll probably be 2 days from when you start. So then if you reset and start again, it'd be another 2 days before you could reset another one.
I would even say longer than 2 days. I'd say nearly a week. I think in other games it was a week.
All right, well, we'll make it a week, so you can't reset until you've played for a week, and then it'd be another week for you to reset again. It's a good idea.
Indy would like to know if history of attacks and defense is going to be in.
Nope, that is on our list, but we'll do that this week.
Yeah, for next stream, I'd say.
We kind of spent this week tackling all the hardest ones to do. So like the substitution system, you know, the abandoning, the ruins, the market, the alliance forums, the raider, and the idle troops were all kind of like the big, you know, elephants in the room for us to do.
Things that were kind of hanging over us, yeah.
Yeah, so it's, now that we've got those done, we're going to be able to do the all the other ones, which are simpler. In the meantime,
Mango King would like to know if you're queuing with Counselor and you have a full queue, it can't do it yet. Will it go on to the next thing? Will it skip the item and go on to the next?
Yeah, they'll kind of just stay down at the bottom. So what will happen is if you know, you queue up a bunch of things, those will go in front, and then when there's nothing actually running, then it will check if it's available or not. So it's not actually, like, let's say I queue up 5 things and then, you know, do something with the counselor, and then those 5 things go through, the counselor says it's still not ready to build yet, and I add another 5 things, then that first one will drop all the way down to the bottom and have to wait for the other 5 to get done before it checks again. As far as speed goes, I think, what was the speed we decided on, Ella?
Didn't we decide to do times 2 with, like, res and capacity and
It would be capacity.
Construction?
No, it would be res and construction will be times 2. Troops
and
will be
raid
regular
loot.
Speed. Travel will be regular speed. Siege ticks will be 1 hour. And then the raids will give 2x loot. So basically, okay. The only thing
yeah,
that will
it's literally only resource. Yeah, like resource accumulation, dungeon loot, and build speed, and everything else is normal, as it would be in a regular server.
Right, so it basically makes everything kind of like a normal speed for attacking and defending and things like that, but then it allows people to grow and build faster, so the third beta kind of gets done quicker than we don't want to have a 6 or 7 month third beta. And especially because people don't want to be stuck finishing up the third beta when we start opening up live servers, which is what would happen if the third beta took that long.
Nihanto is asking, what was it with region map that was causing the lag, and is it fixed now?
Yes, that actually was fixed. That was just something that was happening with the CPU. And I think I fixed regional map, you know, 2 or 3 weeks into.
It was kind of the labels and the layers, and we've reduced on layers now, and Gordy has redone labels.
I actually redid.
I think what Nihanta wants to know is about whether colors for to indicate, like the world map, you can mark enemies a different color and stuff. I think that's what he wanted to know, is if that can happen on region now.
I haven't put that in yet, but I've been thinking about good ways to do that. And as you guys can see, the region map looks really funky right now, and it's because I didn't reset, but I put in a new regional map. So I did finish the new regional map, but it doesn't match up with the old regional map. So a bunch of people have cities and dungeons out in the middle of the water, just because that's where the old continents used to be.
Homer Paul brings up a really good question. How does the game work so far on Windows 10? I can answer that. It was the first thing I tested as soon as I got Windows 10 installed. And the initial load up freeze takes a little bit longer than it does on Chrome to ease up, and that's it. Everything else worked. Now my computer is basically brand new, so that might be just a case by case thing, but for me everything worked perfect.
Man, I'll have to install Windows 10 now and test this out.
I already did. It ran great for me. That initial stall was, you know, like the first time you ever download all of the graphics and stuff for the game.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, I only tried it the once. I didn't even think about trying it again to see if it was all, you know, cached images the second time through.
I think a couple of people are getting a loading screen. I don't know. Let me refresh.
I'm getting a loading screen too, so.
Oh, is it back?
Mine's back.
Is it back up?
Loading.
It's back for me. Move the screen around a little bit, Gordy. Oh, never mind. It went back to loading again. How weird. Are we breaking Hitbox 2 now, guys?
I was going to try to load it up on
Mine is back now, I think.
On Edge, yeah, maybe for the next one. But I did try it out on Edge, and it seems to work pretty well. It works just as well as it did on Chrome. So whatever Microsoft did with Edge, they did a good job. And, I really like Windows 10 a lot better.
I love Windows 10. And Edge, I was really kind of impressed with it for being a Microsoft product. And one of the things that I read, they're actually planning to make sure that JavaScript is supported. And so the same... user scripts and stuff that work on Chrome will be able to be used on Edge too.
And really that will, you know, that's why our script market and, you know, allowing, you know, scripts that are kind of integrated into the game will really be big for people, because then it won't matter what browser you're on. As long as it supports the game, it will support, you know, user scripts, because you can kind of load them as an option in the game instead of having to load them externally.
Can everyone see and hear us now?
Testing.
No, I do not see this game as pay to win. Mostly because the term pay to win means that you can spend a bunch of money and win the game, which is not the case. No matter how much money somebody spends, they cannot just win the game, you know, that quickly or... you know, win it all. We do have a lot of bosses that show up on the regional map all the time. So it is completely possible for people to farm more items than they could ever use. We do limit the amount that people can use items with the charisma system. And we have gotten a lot of complaints saying that it rebuilds too slow, which means that it's doing its job. But
someone's saying there in a chat that it is way over the top. It's the same as it was. The figures are the same as it was in the games. So,
what's over the top?
The charisma levels, the amount of regeneration and the levels.
It's actually the exact same. If anything, the number of bosses that we generate are considerably more. I would almost say 10 times at this point. Because at any given time, there's always, you know, 6 or 7 bosses on any given continent.
I have noticed that too, that there seems to be a lot more bosses, especially early on.
It rebuilds at the normal speed. It is the same speed that everybody's used to from other games. It goes up and down with is it research or is it with, I think it's a research thing.
I think it's research, yeah.
Yeah, research very, only. Tempo bonus doesn't happen with charisma at all, ever.
But
so the highest it'll ever go is 1500 an hour regeneration.
But there's definitely a lot of bosses. I don't remember how many bosses, but there were people out there hitting a lot of bosses. I love having a boss hitting rank. I mean, but if you look at this, some people were, you know, I think that one was a fluke because it was right at the beginning when there was a bunch of extra boss hits. But all these other ones were, 179 bosses. The bosses drop up to 3 items for a level 10, 2 items for a level 9. So people were hitting lots of bosses and getting lots of items to use. So pretty much everything that you can get in the from the items market is you can get from bosses, and there's plenty of them out there.
I'll just remind everybody, it's still a team game too. You cannot win the game alone. You have to be in an alliance. So it's not pay to win at all, because one person cannot win. So one person could spend thousands of dollars and it wouldn't matter. They wouldn't be able to win without an alliance. And we're only giving out 3 crowns per server before we do the 20-day countdown to shut the server down. So, even if you made your own alliance and tried to go it on your own, you're not going to be able to do that here like you could in other games on the really old servers.
And I did calculate it out. It was something like you can use 16 items a day at full Caesar level. That's not an extensive amount of items that anybody can use. You know, 16 is not a lot. So if it needs to be slower, would it be 1 item a day that people can use? Or, you know, what are the suggestions for people saying it's too fast? Yeah. And that's at max speed. So if you're at the highest rank, then you can use 16 a day.
Yeah, seriously, the charisma regen here is exactly the same as it was in other games that we all played.
And it is better than every other game out there as far as, limitations. It takes a lot of, discipline for us to actually keep that in there and not speed it up or take it away completely because, we still have to pay for things in the game, but we do it to make the game better. And, it's different and better than every other game out there because we do limit the amount that anybody can spend or use. And it stops the, things from taking off way too fast, especially early in the game, which is when items are the most valuable. If you can imagine with no charisma at all, people could just have, 500 cities in 24 hours if they, spent enough money. So that is the reason that, and a lot of games are like that. Actually, I'd say 99% of the online games out there, you could jump on and have the equivalent of 500 cities in 24 hours if you spent enough money.
Fact, was it fact? No, Jerrycon asks, is attack warning with sound being considered? A couple of people have asked for this, that when you have an incoming attack, that maybe they could, like, your computer could play some little sound, so that if you are not exactly at your keyboard, that you still get some kind of hint that you are under attack.
We could probably do that.
Yeah, I was thinking it might be good for males as well. When you get a new mail, that you get some
little
sound.
I am going to narrate them all, though. It's going to be a constant, you are under attack. You are under attack.
Yes. Sounds good.
And then you're not going to be held responsible for when people destroy their computers, right?
And, you know, if you guys have a better idea on how to limit charisma that you've seen in other games, because there are none out there, let me know, and we're happy to look it over, but it is the best system out there. It is the most stopping system out there from people paying too much to win, and you don't need to pay anything to play the game. It is, you know, free to play, and you can get items just the same as people. If you hit the bosses, if you don't have time to hit the bosses, then, you know, you can spend money that, you know, you made working while other people were hitting bosses to get the same amount of items, but nobody can spend more or less, no matter the way that they got the items. And if you still don't like it after all of that, then, you know, there's plenty of games out there where you can't spend anything. I don't know of any, but...
There definitely are some. I remember playing one. It was a kind of a spaceship game.
Yeah, it sucked, though.
Astro Empires, was that it?
I don't think Farmville costs anything either.
No, Astro Empires is... I've heard that it's really massively pay to win.
Oh.
But, you know, it's... It's a fine balance, and, you know, we do it with discipline. So it stops a lot of it, and, you know, if people still, you know, don't like the system and the ability to not have to pay anything and get the same advantage as anybody else if they hit a bunch of bosses and take the time to do it, then, you know, maybe these games aren't for them. But no matter where you go and what you do, you're going to have to pay for something somewhere, or it's going to be pretty shitty.
I think the thing is that, I mean, it seems like people want us to make the game completely free, and I don't think that's really a viable business solution. We need to be able to cover our own costs.
Yep.
So,
And raising the price on counselors isn't a solution either, because then we'd lose people who don't want to pay more for counselors per month.
No, I think it's fair the way it is, and, you know, some people are going to like it, some people are not going to like it, but it is what it is, and it is what it's going to be. And, you know, the people that don't like it, you know, don't have to play it, or they don't have to buy them, or they don't have to use it, but it's not, you know, there's only so much we can do, and we can't do shit for free. You know, I don't care about making money, but I'm not going to lose it, so, you know, we have a game.
Fact suggests a tornado siren for the incoming attack warning.
A tornado siren?
Yes.
I don't know, we'll come up with something, but it's not that hard to put sound into the game. The harder part is not making it trigger every time a new attack incoming. So, like, if you were sitting somewhere and it was, you know, all of a sudden...
Suddenly you had 2,000 incoming attacks.
Just play 2,000 times over and over and over again.
Yep.
But loading a single sound wouldn't be hard at all.
Sounds good. And yes, of course, we will give you the option to turn off the sounds.
Nope, no option. If anything, I'm going to figure out a way to make it so that your computer volume stays up at the highest level.
Oh, geez. Tornado sirens all day.
But yeah, there's plenty of sounds out there. And I did already put something in the title bar, so if you're in a different page, you can see that you've got a text incoming too. I don't know if I could make it so that if you're not on the actual tab, if it plays a sound, but I can look into it. Because JavaScript doesn't like to run when you're not actually in the active tab. So, but it's something I'll look into. And no, May, that's not how it works. The amount that you make this, you know, it depends on a large scale of, you know, how many players you have, but at the same time, each player actually costs money to play the game for us. So the more people that are in the game, the more servers, the more back end, the more resources that you actually need. So there's a cost to each player. It's not just, you know, completely free, the amount of players. So if nobody's spending anything, then you're not making anything either. So it's a buy player cost versus pay, and we don't expect people to have to pay anything. It's actually free. We could charge, you know, a subscription fee, but you know, that's not, people don't want to pay subscription fees, and they get angry about subscription fees, and they get angry about, you know, everything. So you're not going to please everybody. You do the best you can, and you know, the people that like it play, and the people that don't like it don't play. It's kind of the way it is.
I think we have a really nice balance, to be honest, because I've not come across any other game that limits you for spending at all the way we do. I've not found a game that does that.
If anybody's played Evony, you can go on to Evony and spend as much money as you want and be the best player in the game within 10 hours, easily. And, you know, it's not fun. Pretty much, you know, the majority of games out there are like that. Even games that are subscription model now are putting in markets where you can buy things to give you an advantage. It's just kind of the trend of the gaming industry, so... For us to limit the amount of spending people can get, it kind of changes, you know, upsets the balance of games where, you know, it's actually strategy that wins. And, you know, of course, there's still going to be people that don't like it. But, you know, when they find something better, I'd be happy to hear it. You know, and even with the levels there are now, you know, there's not enough, you know, to give you that big of an advantage. And the, you know, fact that you need 99 other people to actually win the game changes things around as well.
Yeah, that crown is only ever going to go to Alliances. So, I mean, it... Yes, to a point, it depends on your view of what winning is, but the point of winning the game is getting a crown.
Yep.
Okay, well, it's 3 minutes past now. Does anyone else have any more questions?
We don't have an exact set date yet for the start of beta 3, but probably a couple more weeks.
Yeah, we are going to start some closed testing sessions coming in here. So keep an eye out for that kind of stuff. Yeah, if you guys don't like the game, don't play it. That's all I can say, and it's basically the way everything is.
Greedy wants to know if we're going to have enemy alliance city polls and overviews for Beta 3.
If we're going to have what? Yes.
We are going to. Yeah, export an enemy alliance's cities to what is it, .csv file. Yeah, I guess so.
Trying to think if we did anything else over the time period we can show people before we close it off, but I think we're pretty much done. So yeah, we'll do some closed testing this week. You know, anybody who feels like they want to jump in on closed testing, send a mail to info@gamingaddictstudios.com, and we'll, you know, add people onto the list so we can get a good test. We'll also be doing some bigger come and break our servers test, where we get people to come in and do a lot of attacks against all different places and see if we can find the thresholds and break things, just so that going into beta 3 we know what the limitations are and make sure that, you know, there's no lag running around when people have attacks incoming. So that's certainly something we need to test, and a big issue that we're going to make sure is cleared up before we actually start the third beta. You know, the new regional map has made a huge difference in performance. Not only the, you know, CPU use, but the memory use has gone down a lot. So it helps a lot. We've got a few more features to put in, but then, you know, we're right on track for where we want to be to start the third beta. As far as I'm concerned, if anything, we're kind of ahead of the curve. So I don't see any potential delays in the start.
Yes, I think we're on track.
And I guess we're probably going to cut it off if nobody has any more questions. But thank you guys for joining us for our stream. We'll be on next week to talk about the more stuff that we've done. We do have a forum suggestion post for anything that you want to see. I think we have another post somewhere too, where we are actually listing the stuff we're putting in.
I think it's actually all the same post. It's at the start of the forum post, we have our list, and then people are adding onto it. And we are adding to the list as we get good suggestions. So
if you see something you want added, add it to the list, and we'll see about putting it in.
Yep.
That way we can have the game as finished as possible going into the third beta. And then it just comes down to getting everything properly tested on a large scale, and then going into the live servers, which will be fun.
Exciting, yeah.
But
Real quick fact, wanted to know if we're planning to make any changes to the UI.
Yeah, we have a whole lot of new UI to go in at some point when I get a chance. Yeah, before beta 3.
Yep. I think we've got a full collapsed menu, too, that we're going to be adding in.
Yep.
So it'll give you, like, little buttons on the collapsed menu so you can see full screen, but then, you know, still be able to do stuff as well.
Excellent.
So thank you everybody for tuning in, and keep an eye out for different posts and mails on closed testing, and feel free to mail us if you want suggestions, or if you want to get in on the closed testing, and we'll be on next week to show everybody the new stuff that we've done. So
yes, thank you for joining us.
Thank you, everyone.